In this brief overview, I'd like to introduce our four-part video series that explains the importance and value of power density in modern power delivery solutions. We have two goals for these videos: to promote a deeper understanding of the fundamental principles of high power density designs, and to demonstrate how partnering with TI and our advanced technological capabilities can help improve your efforts to achieve those high power density figures. We'll examine the four most important aspects of high power density solutions, as well as our relevant technologies and products supporting these specific requirements. These four areas are reduced loss generation, optimal topology and control selection, reducing system volume by mechanical and electrical integration of the components, and effective heat removal. Each of these areas will be addressed separately in the following chapters of this video series. But before we start, let's define power density and highlight some important details about comparing solutions based on their power density figures. For power management applications, the definition of power density seems straightforward: the rated or nominal output power of the converter divided by the volume occupied by the converter. But even this simple definition demands a lot of clarification if we want to compare apples to apples based on power density numbers. The output power in this case corresponds to the continuous output power the unit can deliver under worst-case environmental conditions. The relevant power capability may be affected by the combination of ambient temperature, maximum acceptable case temperature, orientation, altitude, and expected lifetime. Similarly, the volume of the power supply can be defined in many different ways depending on the unit's application and construction. Some of the usual variables that can significantly impact the volume and consequently the reported power density of the power supplies are the inclusion or exclusion of EMI filters, fans, housing requirements, input and output energy storage capacitors, which are often required but not part of many of the modularized power supplies. Therefore, it is imperative to know and consider all these variables when comparing reported power density data from the literature. Now, let's have a short historical overview and look at where our fascination with power density comes from and how this trend began. Efficiency was a driving force of innovation in power technology since the early days of switched mode power conversion. Switched mode power converters made it possible to break the deterministic efficiencies of linear power supplies, which were primarily dependent on the input-output voltage ratios and few available topologies. The need for improving efficiency has accelerated significantly from the early 90s, fueled by personal computing and electronics, telecommunications, and advancements in semiconductor technology. Many waves of energy crises and consequent emergence of regulatory requirements made efficiency an even more important attribute of power systems in energy conservation and total cost of ownership. The last decade brought the recognition of power density as the ultimate pinnacle of power system engineering. To better understand the focus on power density, let's look at what it takes to achieve high power density. The special relationship between efficiency, size, and power density is immediately apparent, even for the casual observer. Efficiency is considered the gatekeeper of achieving high power density because it is imperative to reducing the amount of heat that needs to be managed and removed from a device. To take advantage of the higher efficiency, the solution's volume, or its size, in other words, must be shrunk. Achieving both feats at the same time requires a solution that can work efficiently at high operating frequencies. In particular, we need a switching element that can provide low conduction and low switching losses. We will discuss this aspect and TI's industry-leading technologies in the Reduced Switch Losses video in this series. At the same time, we need the right topology to operate at high switching frequencies. Control methods and innovative circuit implementations are also important, considering that most of our converter topologies can be operated in different modes based on the applied control technique. For example, traditional square wave pulse width modulation, zero voltage or zero current transition, or full resonant mode of operation. These and a few additional aspects of topology, control, and circuit IP will be covered in the subsequent video. The scaling effect of higher operating frequency on passive components can shrink the size of a power converter. But there's another very important piece of the power density puzzle, integration. That's the subject of our third video. We will primarily discuss integration happening in the silicon technology itself by integrating power and control elements monolithically. Furthermore, on the semiconductor device side, we will talk about utilizing multi-chip module technology, integrating multiple semiconductor dies, and in many cases, even passive devices like capacitors and magnetic components. While we will not reflect on the mechanical and PCB designs of converters and their enclosures, they are undoubtedly a critical factor in achieving high power densities. Finally, we will call attention to how TI's enhanced packaging and advanced lead frame technologies play an important role in minimizing the temperature gradient between the outside cooling surfaces and the actual silicon temperature. The increased thermal performance based on these technologies together with the accompanying modeling and optimization capabilities not only can enable high power density designs, but also allow long-term, reliable operation of TI's semiconductor devices. Applying these four fundamental principles together is the cornerstone of many successfully executed high power density designs. Thus, the achieved power density can be considered as a report card about how well the designer applied the most appropriate semiconductor technology and whether he or she has selected the right topology, control method, mechanical design, thermal management, and integration strategy. But power density is not just a universal score to rank technical merit in power engineering. If we truly want to understand why power density is important, we have to step back and look at how the industry and society as a whole benefit from higher power density. Smaller physical dimensions usually translate to less raw material usage, which could be indicative of lower material cost. Similarly, smaller size and fewer materials potentially result in lower weight, which is an extremely valuable attribute in power systems in the transportation segment. It can yield fuel savings and/or to the convenience of longer range. With higher power density comes the possibility of miniaturization. Pushing this aspect to the limits has allowed the power conversion industry to create new markets previously unimaginable. As these examples show, power density is important because of well-defined economic advantages for the manufacturer, user, or operator of the system. All of these can be demonstrated in the lower total cost of ownership. I hope this introduction to our power density video series has interested you to learn more about TI and our technologies, which can enable industry-leading power densities from rails as low as 5 volts all the way up to 600 volts and above. We do all of this by utilizing our advanced silicon and high voltage gallium nitride devices, as well as our advanced package technologies. So join us in our journey to dig deeper into the four foundations: reduce switching losses, topology selection control and circuit design, integration, and increased thermal performance. These will all guide you to achieve higher power density for your designs.